eat it up. It's called political buffoonery.
Hello and welcome back to Buffoon of the Week. We're a show that reviews last week's news and current events in search of people who said or did something so colossally dumb that they deserve special recognition for their buffoonery. And you guys get to choose that person by leaving a comment under this video or by voting in our poll at buffoonoftheweek.com. We're back after an extended break after you all crowned Bill de Blasio as the 2020 Buffoon of the Year. Our year-end selection show was our biggest ever, with hundreds of people voting on our website and over 5,000 views. So thank you so much for all the support. Oh, and thanks to those of you who voted in Joe Biden as President of the United States. You just guaranteed us 4 years of some amazing content. You guys, you're the real MVPs. And even 2 weeks into this new administration, there's already so much buffoonery to talk about. So let's jump right into the nominees, because we got some real doozies for you in our first video of the year. So let's get into it right now.
All views and opinions expressed here are not necessarily of the mainstream media and may offend some listeners.
It's called political buffoonery.
This week's first nominee is President Biden's climate czar, former Secretary of State John Kerry. Kerry was out front for the administration, justifying the closing of the Keystone XL pipeline and the loss of tens of thousands of jobs that came along with it. At a White House press conference earlier last Wednesday, Kerry claimed industrial and energy sector workers are victims of a, quote, false narrative based in Trump-era economic policy, and arrogantly told energy workers to just find a new job.
With respect to those workers, no two people are more in this room are more concerned about it. And the President of the United States has expressed in every comment he has made about climate the need to grow the new jobs that pay better, that are cleaner. That, I mean, you know, you look at the consequences of black lung for a miner, for instance, and measure that against the fastest growing job in the United States before COVID was solar power technician. The same people can do those jobs, but the choice of doing the solar power one now is a better choice.
Wow. I guess that's the environmentally friendly way of saying learn to code. And that's fine advice coming from Kerry. According to news reports, Kerry's family owns a private jet, and that jet accumulated an estimated 116 metric tons of carbon over the last year. Now compare that to your typical passenger vehicle that emits 4.6 metric tons of carbon dioxide per year. That's a whole lot of pollution from someone who wants to portray themselves as the savior of the world. But did you expect anything less? The hypocrisy of politicians like Kerry telling you what to do while they do something else is not new at all. But Kerry's flippant response to thousands of workers losing their livelihood with the flourish of President Biden's pen proves just how tone-deaf Democrats like him are to the needs of ordinary Americans. In their fantasy world, it's so easy to just flip jobs when it's not their job on the chopping block. John Kerry's national presence is yet another sign that it's business as usual back in the swamp. But hey, America, that's what you voted for, right? Like what you see so far? Go ahead and smash that thumbs up button. Also, leave us a comment and tell us what you're thinking. And don't forget to subscribe so you never miss another show. This week's second nominee, Robin Hood, did the impossible. It united the country for one common cause. You see, it all started with a group of Redditors at Wall Street Bets, who saw an opportunity to stick it to Wall Street and make a little money at the same time through a coordinated buying plan that drove up stock prices on stocks like GameStop that you might have heard about in the news. That buying plan was accelerated by shorters who are now being forced to cut their losses by buying the stock in large volumes, which drove the stock prices even higher. Everything was going swimmingly until the Robinhood app shut down those retail users from getting in on the action while allowing the larger traders like hedge funds to be able to continue to cut their losses. I mean, what the hell, Robin Hood? Aren't you supposed to steal from the rich to give to the poor? In a blog post, Robinhood attempted to justify the decision to halt and then limit trading, but users weren't buying it. Fox Business's Charles Payne channeled everyone with this response.
The shorts, first of all of this nonsense, all of this noise, all of this whining by Wall Street, it's making me sick. 140% of GameStop was short. I didn't hear one person on TV complaining about Wall Street trying to crush GameStop. 140% short. I told my subscribers, buy this stock, and they made a fortune. I also told them to buy Virgin Space and Virgin. We took profits on that today. Fizz, that's up huge. Tangiers is up huge. Neil, you can't allow Wall Street to short 75% of a stock, and nobody says anything. Crush these companies into the dirt, and then when the individual investor makes money, everyone's up in arms. Oh, they're going to lose their shirt? Don't you think people are trading? If they traded 80 billion shares today, people are ringing a register. I have a kid who bought a house. He made $50,000 and bought a house. So yeah, some people are going to lose and some are going to win. But if they want to change the rules of the game now because the general public is making money after decades of the shorts crushing thousands of stocks into the dirt, I have watched stocks being crushed completely to zero, and no one ever whispered anything because those stocks didn't have Wall Street sponsorship. They were small names. Maybe they went public through a reverse takeover. Whatever it was, the shorts have had their way with the market for decades. No one's ever complained about it. So I am thrilled. If you are going to try to destroy a company by shorting 140% of a stock, you have to accept the fact that individual investors are playing the same game that you're playing, and now you're losing.
You know what, Charles? We couldn't have said it better. Robinhood should face class action for closing off the market to retail purchasers. Aren't we supposed to have a free market? Robinhood and the other gatekeepers of Wall Street are okay with the little guy losing hundreds, so long as rich investors don't get called out on their own risks. When you brand yourself as the company helping the little guys, and then exactly at the point in time when the little guy starts to make a move, you shut it down, it becomes very clear who you are actually for. Hey Robinhood, maybe consider a name change. And for the first time in 2021, we present to you two very worthy buffoons. But who takes the crown this week? Tell us who you got for this week's Buffoon of the Week. As you guys can see, we've made a few changes around here. Special shout out to our friend Conscience. Check out his YouTube channel. He's letting us use his awesome track, Political Buffoonery Part 1. We really appreciate it, and we hope you like it so that you come back next week, where we'll have two more nominees, but only one can be Buffoon of the Week.